Hello, welcome to this DeskProto tutorial video. My name is Lex and I want to tell you what DeskProto is about and also show the basic workflow using the wizard interface. Yes, the wizard interface is the easy interface for novice users. The other interface, the dialog-based user interface, will follow in part two of this video. Okay, DeskProto is CAM software, computer-aided manufacturing, so it can be used to calculate toolpaths for a CNC milling machine, so a computer-controlled milling machine that can be any type of machine. I have a few shown over here, a large industrial machine, a large flatbed router like this one, a desktop machine, it can be a China-made, a low-cost China-made machine, a homemade machine, any machine can be used. As I said, computer-aided manufacturing. So what is the basic workflow here? In order to get to use one of those CNC machines, you need a three-step process. Three steps. The first step is CAD software. You need to use a program, a design program, CAD program, to make your design. You cannot do that in DeskProto. The CAD design is transferred to DeskProto via some CAD format. CAD file. In DeskProto, you calculate a toolpath and save them in a toolpath file, for instance, G code or any other format that can be used. And the third step is the control software. The control software is the software that imports a toolpath file and will make the machine follow those movements. Well-known control software packages are Mac3, Linux CNC, Garble, Eating CNC, well, many more do exist. Okay, that about the place of DeskProto in the design process. Now, let me show you how it in fact works by starting DeskProto. As you see, we start the free edition. You can download and use that as long as you like without any charge. The video, by the way, also applies to the three paid editions. These simply offer more functionality than the free edition. This free edition also allows you to start each of the three paid editions in trial mode, so you can experiment if a paid license would be okay for you. The trial mode is fully functional. However, a watermark, the trial cross, will be visible on the screen in the toolpath and here also on the resulting parts. Okay, the free edition doesn't have a trial cross. Let's start that. And we want to use the wizard. In this video, I want to show you the wizard interface. Here you can see three different wizards are available, which reflects the three different types of CAD data that DeskProto can work with. Vector data, so a two-dimensional drawing made out of lines, vectors. Geometry data, which is a 3D design saved as an STL file. And the third one, the bitmap machining, where you can import any digital image which will be converted to a 3D relief that then can be machined. But I'll show you all three types. First, the vector machining. Five wizard pages in this wizard, so we continue to page two. And the first question is, which CAD data file do you want to use? I want to use the beer tray, the millimeter version, the inch version is for inch users. Open, it's loaded here, you can see drawing with a beer tray, room for seven beer glasses or coffee cups or whatever, and that's what we want to cut out of a flat sheet of material. I'll leave all settings as much as possible on default to make this a short video. The only thing I have to change here is the machining depth. I'll put that to 11 millimeter. Size of material block, I'll keep that default as well. And I'll calculate toolpath, which is done for profiling strategy. So the cutter follows the profile, follows the lines in the geometry. As you can see here on the outside, and for the holes automatically on the inside. And the cutter is too thick to fit into the
curves of the text, so that will be ignored. Still, one thing I forgot to do, I have to make sure that the part remains connected to the rest of the material sheet, so I need support tabs. I'll simply use support default tabs and calculate again. And here you can see the cutter rises a bit, so some material remains there, which is a support tab. And we can see that on the final screen by showing a simulation. This is what will be machined by these toolpaths. Okay, the last step is simply to write the NC program to a file, and a warning here, I ignore that. I call it vector test. Yes, here we are, and that file can be sent to the milling machine. Okay, so far a very brief introduction of vector machining. I'll start a new project, don't save. Let's again start the wizard, and now I want to continue with basic geometry machining. I forgot to show the machine to be used. After installation, the DeskProto will ask you which machine you have, so that should already be set to the correct machine. Okay, geometry machining, again 5 wizard pages. And again, start with loading the CAD data, and I use this simple perfume bottle. Here we are, we can look at it from all sides. And the first thing we have to realize, the cutter comes from the positive Z direction, so we have to rotate it to make it make this useful, because otherwise the cutter can't reach below all parts of this geometry. So I will make the front on top, and now we have, when the cutter comes from the top, I can machine half a bottle. Again, more details in the other videos. I say upper half of geometry. I made the cutter, no, leave it that way. Calculate, here we are. So the toolpath, they will machine the complete rectangular block, material block that we defined. And again, on the last page, I can make a simulation, and this is what will be machined. The thick cutter is a bit too thick to reach into this ridge here, so some rest material will be present, but still a nice bottle. Again, I can write the NC program file. It will take about half an hour, 40 minutes, and send that to the milling machine. So that is a very, very short introduction of geometry machining. Finish. Again, a new project. Don't save. Again, start the wizard. And the final thing to show you in this short video is the bitmap machining. So then we import a bitmap image, a digital image. I have a very simple one in the DeskProto samples, which is the XYZ logo. Only 2 colors are present, black and white. And what DeskProto does is convert the color value of each pixel to a Z value. So I want to have the black on top of the block, so the black is 0, and white can be -2 millimeters, that's okay. The size about 300, I will make it a bit smaller, make this 100 millimeter wide text thing, and well, that's it. I can go next. I'll select a cutter which is a bit smaller, say 2 millimeter, and calculate toolpath. Again, the complete block is machined, as you can see here. Again, I can, on the final page, make a simulation. So this is what we are going to machine. Cutter was a bit too thick, as you can see here, to fit into this this hole. So a thinner cutter would be better, but still, it's absolutely clear what happens here. And when the image has indeed gray values, like a digital photo, there will be a real, more complicated 3D relief that will be machined.
Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this quick introduction into the DeskProto wizards, whether it is here 2D milling machining, 3D machining, or here the result of bitmap machining. As said, more introduction will follow in part 2 of this video. For now, interesting that you can download the free edition of DeskProto from our website. We hope that you will do so. Thank you for watching.